Have you ever been asked a question after your presentation or during the meeting at workplace? If yes, were you nervous? Or even if you were able to handle the questions, you did not know how to better manage this. Today's video, we are going to learn 4 tips on how to respond to questions like a master accomplished speaker. Are you ready? If yes, let's get started. Welcome to Grow with Girija, where we learn about public speaking, communication, and life. Imagine yourself presenting to a group of people where during or after the presentation, someone asks you a question. Isn't it simple to provide the answer? With my experience, I would say no, because it's not just the answer you provide, but how you answer, how you handle the question, and how you handle the audience also is a crucial skill. So the question is, how do you become a master responder? There are 8 tips to ace it. This video is part 1 of 2 videos on this topic. In this part 1, we are going to look at 4 tips on how to focus on the answer. And in the second video, we are going to learn 4 additional tips which focus on how to answer. So let's dive into it. Tip number 1. Listen to the question. Did I just say that? Isn't it obvious that you have to listen to the question? It's like saying the sun has to rise for it to become morning. But in my opinion, it is not that straightforward. Being in front of the audience is nerve-wracking. And by exposing yourself, because you have allowed the audience to ask yourself a question, you are already under pressure and you are hoping that the audience does not ask you a difficult or tricky question. So you are under stress. And what happens when you are under stress? Your ability to pay attention drastically reduces. With that so much chatter in your head, you almost don't listen to the question. So what do? Practice listening. But how? First of all, when you are ready to listen to the question, take a deep breath. It will calm your nerves. And then listen to the question like your life depended on it. And this next tip is going to help you remember the question. Tip number 2, paraphrase the question. Paraphrasing means taking something which has been said and saying it in a different way while retaining the meaning. But the question is, why should I put effort in paraphrasing the question and repeating it to the audience? Because the benefits are multifold. First, let me ask you this. Will you be able to paraphrase the question if you don't remember it? I don't think so. By paraphrasing, you are forcing yourself to pay attention and to remember the question. Second, by paraphrasing, you are clarifying and refining the question. You are bringing out the core question from within the question. How? Let's look at an example. Suppose you delivered a presentation about healthy eating and someone in the audience asks you, "Does it mean I can never eat a burger?" You can paraphrase it by saying, what you are asking is that should all my meals be as per the standards of healthy eating? This is the actual question behind the question. Third, by paraphrasing, you detach the question from the person who asked it. And that way, you don't take it personally and you can even change the tone of the question. Take for example, somebody asks, why should I follow this approach? Doesn't it sound a little direct and intimidating? You can change the tone by paraphrasing and saying what you're asking is that what are the benefits of this approach? And fourth, by paraphrasing, you help all the audience members hear the question and understand it better. Remember, you don't have to paraphrase all the question. Use your judgment. Tip number 3, don't assume the question. Not always the question will be straightforward or clear. and we end up answering the question so many times by assuming certain aspects of that question. You are not obliged to answer the question without understanding. So if the question is not clear, ask the person who asked it to repeat it, to clarify, or ask them what specifically they would like to know. You will get the clarity. You just have to ask for it. Tip number 4, answer the question. This sounds again something so obvious. Of course you will answer the question. Even for that, I remind you that take a deep breath so that you feel relaxed. What I'm saying here is that keep your answer focused on the question which has been asked. This question answer session is only a small portion of the overall presentation. So be specific, be brief with your answer. If you need to provide more details, take it outside the meeting, take it offline. This is not the time to show off your knowledge. Be respectful to everybody's time and allow everybody or most of the people to ask more questions. These tips apply to the question and answer session of a presentation, but you can even apply these to your team meetings. Remember, it's not just the answer which you provide, but how you answer also reflects your skills as a speaker. In part 1 of these videos today, we focus on the tips related to the answer. If you like this video, like it and subscribe to my channel to support it. In part 2 of this video, we will learn skills and tips about how to handle difficult situations, how to focus on your audience, and finally how to provide closure to a question. See you in another episode of Grow with Girija.